Okay? One reason that anybody can do. And that's having a lot of energy. That's having a
lot
of energy. And I see a lot of you are snuggling and you know like they're not even thinking sitting straight, what will you achieve in life? Are you understanding? Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you here. Please, a round of applause for all of you. Thank you very much. It feels like I'm talking to the youth of the country, the future of our country. And I'm going to talk about this a little bit more. I'll tell you about my story. Yeah, I was just another guy, just like you guys maybe. No, not like you guys. I was not as smart as you guys. You know, I don't think I attended even one seminar like this ever. Okay, so you guys made a decision. That's the stuff. You make decisions. That's the stuff. Congratulations to all of you. I don't know, most of you are, I think, here by will, right? You yourself have come. Yes or no?
Yes.
I don't hear you, man. Yes or no?
Yes.
Thank you very much. Yes, you're here by choice. You're not here by chance. Ladies and gentlemen, what happens when you come to places like these? You know, you meet other people, you interact, you know, you become more aware. You become more
aware.
And better awareness, better choices. Better choices, better decisions. Better awareness, more awareness, or better awareness, better choices, and better choices, better results. You understand? So that's absolutely fantastic. I didn't know so much of this, okay? I was just another regular guy, used to bunk classes. Like, just like, I don't know, maybe some of you do that. Yeah? So, I passed out school very, very, it was very difficult, okay? Believe me, like, 9th exams were like the end of life. By the way, I must say that in the 5th till 4th grade, I used to come like 1st or 2nd in class, and in the 5th class, my parents sent me to hostel. They were really happy. I was happier. Okay. And in 5th class, I was at hostel. I was at public school, Dakshaya. So, you know, as soon as I went there, within the first year, you see the change that I had in myself. From, I think, whatever I used to get, I'm just guessing, maybe whatever. Like, second must be some 70, 80, 90% maybe. I got down to 49%, I think, in 5th standard, you know. And my parents had it, okay, and they were like, okay, and you know, I used to get constant, rigorous counseling. And by the end of 6th year, I was pulled out from there. So I had a very normal college life, school life. And then I wanted to be an engineer myself. I wanted to be an engineer. My time, it was like everybody wanted to be an engineer or a doctor. And I studied really hard. Yeah, you believe that? So, and my parents, they're from the defense background, okay, my dad's in the forces. I didn't give a shit to studying too much, okay, I didn't like it. In fact, I would do anything that is possible except for sitting in the class, okay. I could do SUPW, everything, okay, from woodwork to swimming to NCC to tabla, harmonium. I can do pretty much all of this, including sewing, okay, sewing. You name it. But you know why? Because I didn't like the classrooms and the entire education system too much, okay? And it's nothing new, right? I'm sure a lot of people don't like it, but you know, you don't have too much of a choice. You don't choose, oh, you're not the right one. Doesn't happen like that. Anyway. So, just not a regular guy, I did everything so that I could avoid studying NCC and computer competitions, swimming, whatever you name it. By the time I came to 11, I thought that I have to do engineering and this is my life, purpose, mission, goal, whatever. And I knew that there's no way that I can make it. You know, there's no way that I'm getting an IIT or something to grad. Because I was like 50, 60% max. That's good. Okay, that's really good. Like, that was my dream. Okay, and then, so I thought, what's the way? We researched and, you know, my mother was really serious about my career. So she was, so she got to know that if I would go to Birla Public School, Pilani, in my 12th, so 11th, till 11th I was here at the Aung Public School, Bolangam. Okay. So, 12 I did Birla Public School, Pilani, because from there if I top in the first 15 in any subject, I could get one day, you know, preference or something like that. So I could get BITS Pilani. That was like a nice way we worked out. So we went to BITS Birla Public School, Pilani. I completed my 12 there. Hopefully, thankfully passed. And, you know, by the time I really saw that life closely, I knew that this is not what I'm doing. Engineering sucks. Okay, like this is my perspective, and from my perspective, I'm sure some of you may love it, okay? So I was like, I can't study like these guys, okay? These guys would study through the night, okay? Through the night, that's not me. So, and that was all that I knew. I didn't know a lot of gyan in life, okay? So what I did was, I thought what to do. I, you know, went up to my parents, I told my dad, Dad, you know, this doesn't work, you know. Like, I've never been good at this. And he's like, yeah, I know. You only want to be the engineer. Okay. So he told me, and we had a discussion, and he said that, you know, you should let this engineering be. I think you should figure out something. So we you know, thought of some options, what are possible. Hotel management stuff, you know. And, you know, that's where all the losers go. No, I'm just kidding, okay. But at least that was my case. A lot of smart people go these days, by the way. So I thought hotel management sounds like a good idea, and my dad convinced me that, you know, if you do engineering, you'll be amongst the last 3-4 guys in the college campus, and if I do hotel management, there's a higher possibility that I'll be in the first 3-4 guys in campus, okay, in college campus. So I said, sounds like a plan. And another friend of mine who was in IHM Mumbai, okay, hotel management college in Mumbai. He was telling me, I asked, you know, how's the college in this? And he was like, oh, this is fantastic, you know, 8th floor, right by the beach, the other, you know, it is really awesome. What a life, Mumbai, and life is all that I was thinking about. Why am I telling you this? My story is because, you know, at no point in time did I know that this is how it's going to work out. Okay? I was just doing what I would love doing. What I thought, okay, I should do this. Based on whatever little I knew, okay? So, I did hotel management eventually. I got to hotel management campus and all that. Hotel management started and I was surely serious about, I want to be, you know, a steward and serving, and maybe sometimes I want to be a chef. You know, this oscillated between. And by the time the campuses were to come, I decided that this also sucks. It's not good enough. You know, because it's so stupid. These guys don't pay enough, you know. Being a steward, they don't pay you enough and they make you work like dogs. You know, it's real hard for you to work 12, 30, 30, 40, 40 hours, I think, and the pay that they give you, I don't think this is commensurate with, you know, I'm willing to work hard, hello? I'm willing to work hard, and I don't want to get those, you know, the little pay that you give. Make sense, yes, no?
Yes.
I'm willing to work hard, but I want to do shit in life, I want to grow, okay? Okay, so then campuses came. I sat for the campuses. That's just for fun, okay? Just for fun. A lot of my friends told me that, you know, you please sit in my campus because in the group discussions I would help other people get selected. So that was all my role was. And I sat for 4 campuses. I got selected in all 4. That was by chance, okay? Because apparently they were looking at these skills, you know, in the GD. Who's not trying to beat the other, okay, and who's trying to promote the others, you know? And my job in the GD was... I was there just for fun, okay? Like, because I told you, I want to do an MBA. So I knew that this life sucks and I want to do an MBA. And, you know, MBA was the hot thing to do because hotel management is not what I want to do, okay? So, campuses, and they told me because I couldn't believe myself that this really happened to me. And I tell you, after my 12th, there was another place that I went to for hotel management. This was Welcome Management Institute, where they had a GD. And I was this really talkative guy, and we had this GD round. I thought I really cracked it, okay? And when the results came, they didn't select me. This was, I think, after 12th class, okay? 10th or 12th, or whenever they have that STEP program or theirs. And I was really upset. And I went up to that person when the results were announced, my name didn't come. Like, I went up to the person, hello. Like, he forgot me. I was the guy who spoke the most. And I made all the sense. And he's like, no, you're not selected. And my dad was also there. He explained it to my dad, you know, because I wouldn't just give up. I was like, no, hello, you got it wrong. Are you understand? That's so stupid, man. But then what happened is, in my college, because that was the first time I've really felt failure, okay? Like, I used to care a lot. But this time it hurt, okay? Because this was career. You know, till now, my parents were paying the bills and everything. You know, it doesn't hurt you so much when you're talking about making a life and, you know, starting a career. Things get serious, okay? So that I failed there. Surprisingly, you know, this college time was my, you know, comeback time. I cracked all 4 of them because I told you, because my job was to say, oh yes, Mr. Tasha has a great point. You know, that's all that I was doing. And so I was selected on all 4. Then and I had to do MBA. That's what I had also had in mind. You know, I wanted to do MBA. When the results came, so the Hyatt International Corporate Leadership Training Program, which is a top rated by Forbes magazine program. And they said, okay, so hotel management, and I think it was front office or something. I said, I want this. Okay? That was like the best that you could get in hotel management, okay? And I said, I want to do this. He said, what are you saying? Like, how? Why? And then, so I didn't take it so seriously because I wasn't serious in the first place. And then I think Phoenix Mills or someplace in Mumbai, we were just chilling, I think, at the night. And one of these other ladies, her name is Meera, I think Meera Rajendran or another one, Tanushree was. She told me, are you crazy? Like, if you do an MBA, what you would do is, after an MBA, you'll have to work as a trainee for a couple of years and you'll have to work up the ranks, you know? Or maybe something like that. Here in the management training program that you got selected for, in the corporate leadership training program, you would straight away become an assistant manager and get to join a company and say, yeah, this makes sense. Are you guys understanding? I don't know. Hello? Thank you. So I was like, yeah, this makes sense. So I usually call up Mr. Richard Todd, who took my interview. It was really grueling. The interview process was crazy. I was like, what, man? You're selecting for NASA or what? Anyway, so I called Mr. Todd and I said that, hello sir, is that offer still open, please? You know, I'm really interested in this. And he said, but I also told him that, you know, but I want to do it in HR, not in front office. You know what HR is? HR, human resources, that's like a cool job. Okay, suited, booted, varo chill. That's what I thought, and I keep on going. Thank you very much for your love. So, I didn't want to do front office. You know what front office is, right? Head of reception, head of admin. That will impress me too much. So, this is not a sorted guy, but sure, okay? And I have not told you most of it, all my suspensions and how they happened. I was thrown out of college and school both. And so many times, you know, it really made me strong as a person. And changing so many schools and colleges, I met so many more people. All of this really added. At that point in time, I was thinking like, this doesn't work, life is just testing me, you know? This is trying my patience too much. Anyway. So I joined the Hyatt National Corporate Training Program. So he's I had called Mr. Richard Todd, that is that office still open. He was really kind, he's an Aussie, he's an Australian, and he was really, really kind. He was life-changing in my life. And he said, oh well, yes Saurabh, I could see. And then he hung up. You know, that's what you don't like. Abhe nahi karna, bata de nahi karna. I had to wait for a while, and after some time, this gentleman called me back and said, there is a possibility, and I wrote him a nice email, I'm the best, this, that, you know, basically, you want me, you know, something like that. I was in HR, Hyatt International Corporate Leadership Training in India, which has never happened in the history of India, for Hyatt. I'll tell you why, because they take MBAs with experience. So, I was the first person who got through, with another person, and there was another person who was technically, I think, competent. I was just like that guy. So I was really proud. For the first 2-3 months in my job, I joined job. For the first 2-3 months, I used to laugh at myself. Hello, Saurabh, like you really, you're an HR? Like you're such a, you know? Like I'm not serious guy, okay? And you would always be on the other side of the rules and everything. And now here you're telling others, when I used to tell, oh, you don't do that. I would laugh at myself, hello, yeah. So life was good, really good, but yes, one thing Mr. Richard Todd hired, and of course it starts with my parents and teachers, professors, I can't thank them all enough together here in this limited time, but just principally, I think they played such a big role. I got my letter to join my first job before I joined the job at my place, at my, you know, where I used to stay, my place. A letter came nicely wishing you that we look forward to your joining. They made it so beautiful. I fell in love with the company before joining. Okay? You know, because that's the first time. Okay? Now you ask me, maybe it's different. No, it's not. I still love the company. I'm going to come back to that job. They sent me this letter, and here they sent the air tickets, and you know, I landed at Mumbai airport for the orientation at Grand Hyatt Mumbai. It sounds nice. And I get down from the plane, and as soon as I get down from the plane, on the tarmac, there's a person who says, you must be Saurabh Kaushik, right? I'm like, ooh. Yeah, so, this is completely unbelievable, okay? Like, for a person like me, I had not seen this, okay? And you don't expect this at all. Yeah, so I was really moved, and the orientation program that I had, which was conducted by Mr. Richard Todd, was another level, okay? Life-changing, completely life-changing. And I understood that quality is important, standards are important, you know, have some ethics of yourself, respect yourself, all of those basics. I'm sure the speaker who came before me did a fantastic job. He covered all the great young in the world, and that's why I thought that he would speak again, okay? So I had a fantastic start, worked really hard. I worked like 72 hours at a stretch, 72 hours at a stretch I used to work. Worked like crazy, because I wanted to do something about it. And I thought that this is my time to work. and you know, I chill. So that was, so I'm a lazy guy, by the way. I don't like to work kind of guy. And here I am, I want to really slog because I want to have a good life. You understand? You know what a good life is, right? I'm sure a lot of us want that. Yes or no?
Yes.
Wonderful. So I want to have a good life, and I worked really, 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 really hard. And I became an assistant manager personnel in a span of 1.5 years, okay? With a lot of ups and downs, but yeah, 1.5 years, assistant manager personnel, it's like assistant manager HR half. And then in 3 months, I thought that training is a better thing to do, you know? Training also should be there, so I tried for that, and I became assistant manager HR. So personal and training. And I'm just telling you how my life moved on, okay? So I'm now assistant manager HR, and then someone decides to make shift me to an operational department because of certain reasons. So I shifted to that operational department, which is front office, which I didn't want to do. So I basically did all of these things, and life was just here and there, and you know, people just made me slow, and people would not help you, okay? Generally, it happens because you're working with the average people, and average people don't want to help you. They won't. It seemed to me, I'm telling you from my perspective, I'm not telling you the real truth. The real truth is, what is the truth of life? I'm not about the truth of life, okay? I'm talking about what happened to me, okay? Like, people would not support you as much as you would want them to. And they would maybe at times be a barrier, is what I felt then. So as science progressed, I used to just know one thing that Mr. Richard Todd trained me to work really hard and told me that just work hard. Just work really hard at whatever life throws at you. Okay, just do your best. And absolute best. Not because it's their standard, but because it is my standard, you know? That's really, really essential because it is your standard, because you want to make it big. So yeah, that's what I followed. And about 3.5 years or so at Hyatt, I got a call from Mr. KP Singh, for DLF Emporio. I don't know if you know DLF Emporio.
Yes.
Yeah? So DLF Emporio, for their HR, Mr. KP Singh had asked Hyatt's resident manager to join and open that place for their hospitality division. So he called me, that you know, I want someone to take care of my HR. Could you, you know, are you open for this? And I was like, yeah, why not? You know? And so that's the first career move that I made, because my boss moved to this other company, DLF Emporio. He was heading the hospitality sets and zest and all of the hospitality things. So that was my first jump. My boss moved. From there, so basically at all of these places, I just did my best. That's it. I didn't need too much. I was just doing what I loved doing. Whatever I got, I just did it really passionately. Because, you know, if you do something really passionately, you'll fall in love with it. I don't know if you ever realize it. If you're really writing something because you really mean to write it, I'm not saying that your writing has to be good, okay? Your writing can be like really bad. But if you're just really doing it, your writing will also become nicer for that value. When you're really with all full intent, when you're writing something that you want to write, your writing will be nicer. And you will love the process of doing it. And if you're fully dedicated in this because you have this bigger calling, bigger purpose, for me, I just knew I want to make it big. That's all. And I didn't know much. And I know for sure, after counseling or consulting or coaching, some of the best in the country. Okay, I'm talking about Ivy League students, maybe more relevant to you, from Harvard, Cornell, MIT, and those students, to startup entrepreneurs who have very little, to seasoned business owners who've been in the business for 20, 30 years, and I coach them now, from across the country, from around the country, to leaders of Fortune 500, some of the best Fortune 500 companies, okay? This is what I do now. And I'm telling you that you will never have enough data. You will never know everything. You know, so I also didn't know too much. Anyway. Yeah, so that's how life happened, and so DLF and the DLF Galaxy Hotel in Gurgaon, I got the call from there. I got many calls from there, and I didn't want to join because I was really happy in my job. And then he said that, you know, Saurabh, tell me your price, you know, what's your price? I'm like, yeah, this sounds like music, I like it. let me give this a shot. Because, so at every place, my work was so good that it got noticed beyond a certain point in time. People would know, and believe me, people are noticing. People are noticing, it's just that at that point in time you don't feel that, you know, this is going to add up to anything. So when I was at Hyatt, they made me slog, okay? So there was one manager there who didn't like me, and he said that you're going to clean this entire housekeeping store, which has not been cleaned for years, okay? He said, you're going to clean this, take everything out, just clean it and just put it in. For what? For you, just to satisfy your freaking ego. For what? For your ego trip, basically. But all I knew was just do your part. Just do your part, that's all. So I did it, and today I know more about housekeeping than any other person at my level knows. Are you understanding? I know more about housekeeping, for food and beverage, for front office, all of these, because I did it so passionately. I was really engrossed, totally in love with what I was doing. Are you understanding?
Yes.
Wonderful. So Galaxy happened. I did a great job there. Great, I'm saying by their standards. Great also by my standards. I didn't care what anybody else was saying. I'm not talking about living anybody's asses for sure. I'm saying that you do your part really, really, really well. And that's all. And it will be noticed. So Galaxy has to do that. I did for about 8 months. And then the owners saw that you guys have been able to bring about a change. And in HR people, I don't know how much. So in most companies, generally, they don't work so hard, okay? And I would work till really late nights as well. So I am completely cutting out the party scene from here, from all of this picture, because I am sure everybody doesn't know about partying. So yeah, I had my fair share, it was super fun. I'm taking it out. But that was like, you know, we would go for a party at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the night. 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock in the night, and finish by 4:30 or 5 maybe, and then come back to office at 8:30, and my boss would be like, hey, Saurabh, are you on drugs? You know, he's like, this is my eyes on the corporate, you know. So anyway, so all of that said, I've not told you what, but yeah, since time is limited, I want to quickly wrap this up and ensure that you get some learning from my life. Yeah, so Galaxy Hotel. I was heading there, HR as human resource manager, and I was there for about 8 months, and the owners saw that I was, you know, being able to make a difference, and he called me that sort of Kingdom of Dreams. Have you heard of Kingdom of Dreams?
Yes.
Yeah, so about 3 years back, around 3 years back, I was the general manager HR for that place as well. For 3 to 4 years, 3.5 years or so before that. So about 5.5 years back or so. Did a fantastic job there. People loved me. People loved me. And I was really strict as well. This is what people told me. People would be really scared of coming around you. So if anybody's not done something right, okay? Or if you're on the other side, but people would love me otherwise. So anyway, what I'm going to say is that you just do your part right, that's it. You just do your part really, really well. That's the sum total of all that I've been able to understand. And do it with a lot of passion, with a lot of energy, with a lot of vigor. That's to sum it up principally. And you will never know enough. That's another one. So yeah, Kingdom of Dreams, and one day, I decided to call it quits. And I left from there, started my company, Peopleist India. And I had people who joined us, joined me. There was Ankit Chapoli, who was the first person to join, and there is Himanshu somewhere here, who's the third person to join. And they all joined. So when I left Kingdom of Dreams as the general manager HR for about 3.5 years, I was on the streets, okay? Like, now I'm not general manager HR. So they told me that, sir, you want to come with you and I want to join. I principally don't like such behavior. You understand? If you're a certain person in the company and you lead other people, leave with you, that's not a great idea. So when I left, I told them, you know, Ankit, you know what happened is, general manager, HR and all of that, Saurabh Kaushik was there then. Today it is just Saurabh Kaushik and I have 2 months salary in reserve, that's it. I have no money. And I don't even know if I'll be successful or not. That is what I told him, I knew I was successful, I would be successful. I knew if you work, you've got to be successful, there's no way. I'm telling you, I can literally guarantee that anybody who really wants to be successful will be successful, and there is nothing that can stop you. And you just have to have the right plan, okay? You just have to work really hard, and of course, some wisdom, okay? And how that comes, I will tell you all of that. It's just that we don't have so much time, so I'm quickly moving past this. So then he came, he told me that, so I want to work with you. I said, okay, well, that's a great idea, but you know, I will not be able to pay you. And when will I be able to pay you? I don't even know that. Because what if my business doesn't take up in the first month, maybe second month, maybe the third month also? So then, you know, what is highly likely is that he may come up and tell me that, you know, it's not working out, and you know, I think I'll have to get back to a job because you're not being able to pay me salary, which is fair. But do you think I can afford that? Because I've invested so much in him in the first 2 months or 3 months, and we've not even started working. This is what I'm thinking. That if I invest in him, at the startup phase, if I'm going to train him so much on all of this, and then he says that it's not working out, then that's not going to work, right? So I said that you want to have your skin in the game, okay? And I said, along with this, there's another thing happened. When I resigned, the person I resigned to, he gave me 1 lakh rupee cash. That, Saurabh, I know you want to do something, please take this as a token amount. And I'm with you in whatever you do. So this is what happened isse pehle. And so then when he said this, I said, will you put in money in this? He said, yeah, how much? Now he's not from a great background, just like mine, you know, it's just very, very normal, fair backgrounds, normal backgrounds, humble backgrounds. He said, yes, I will. I said, 1 lakh rupees. He said, yes, I will. And he didn't have, I'm sure, 2,000 rupees saving also. Okay, not 2,000 rupees. And he invested 1 lakh rupees just as a show of interest that I'm here through thick and thin, whatever come. And this is about 3 years back. And here he is with us, you know, he could have left. A lot of respect, a lot of love to him and a lot of him. And I don't know where Himanshu is here. Yeah? Hey, HT. So, wonderful. So these guys, whatever I've been able to do or we've been able to do in this much while is all because of Viv and our team. We have got, the core team started with just 6 people and every single person paid money to join for no guarantees. Can you imagine that doesn't happen? They paid 1 lakh rupee for nothing. And with the only surety was that, imagine I have farted this money. Immediately, because you're not getting anything back. Because you know how expenses happen? You don't even realize, you know, money blows like anything. And my burn rate in regular job was like 2 lakhs plus per month. So my last salary was 2 lakhs per month. The last job offer that I declined was 5 lakhs plus per month. So I'm just giving you a nice estimate of things. So I spend fast, okay? So I think it gives you some idea of my story. And there's a whole lot of details, of course, can't summarize in this. I'll tell you some basics that I've been able to pick up. Are you interested?
Yes.
Some basic concepts that have really made a difference, okay? Yeah, do what you love. I did what I love. Okay. So 5 truths. You may not completely know how. You know, do what you love. You may not know how. And no one else also knows this, of course, because you don't know it. And nor did I also know that I've told you. Life's short. Life's short. We all know this. Do you guys know that you're going to be able to reach home today? There was a soccer team which was playing soccer, and one side of the team, lightning struck and everybody passed out.
Yes.
So unfortunate. So there is no guarantee of what's going to happen. Okay? Might as well do what you love. Okay? Let's come back. You're going to die either way. Okay, so don't think too much about it. So you're understanding what is the future? Most jobs that you know, most, okay, education and everything is coming online. Everything's, so just think about the future of technology, okay? The future of work. It's going to be really, really, really difficult. That's fact A. Technology is going to take away most jobs that exist. Most. There's hardly very few that will not be taken away. And then take fact B. This is fact A. Take fact B. India will have the highest youth population in the world. So people like you, there's going to be ever so much, so many of them. Okay? That's fact B. And then, yeah, the marketplace. The marketplace automatically disciplines people. People who don't perform. Are you understanding? People who don't get themselves moving. People who don't hustle up. People who don't have the energy and don't, you know, do something. You're understanding? There's a lot of people moving to entrepreneurship. You know why? There was a research done and it was found that it is not so much because they have a passion or a dream or something. It is because they're not finding enough jobs. Enough jobs that they like enough, you know. So they want to do what they can do. And then there is limitless. With these, with technology, with youth, and so much more youth, possibilities are limitless. I'm not saying that the future is going to be bang, okay? There are whole new, a lot of startups coming in, new concepts, new innovations. The future is limitless, but you know what? The worst thing that can happen to mankind is happening now. The worst, which is a lack of awareness. And this is going away. This is going away because people like you are taking initiative. I'm just saying this one little thing and I want you to really pay attention. Pay attention, everyone, please. When I say this, I really mean it. You are the real future. Sounds small, right? Albert Einstein? One day he was sitting like you guys probably. Albert? Even Mohan. Mohan? Das Karamchandra Gandhi. What? You're getting it, right?
Yeah.
It's just people like you. You gotta just believe in yourself and do something. It's not so much about thinking and so much about question. You know, Socrates, the Greek philosopher, he said that we are all born with all the genius that we will ever need in lives. We are all born with all the genius, with all the knowledge that we will ever need in our lives. It's not about the right question. It's not about the right answers. It is about the right questions, asking the right questions. For that, you've got to be doing things. If you don't do, if you sit and think, you will never have enough data. You'll never make any progress. Don't overburden yourselves. Just get doing with whatever you think you really, really love. You're understanding? And how you do every single thing has an answer. Okay, I would really love to help you guys. Please feel free to reach out to me if there's anything I could help you with. There is so much value. The right guidance means everything. The right guidance can mean everything. You know, people get to realize their passions and dreams after 10, 15 years. Look at the lost opportunity. Are you understanding? We have a bright future with technology, innovation, our youth population being ever higher, and with education reaching far deeper than it has ever reached. I see a grand future. I just want you to also see it. Yeah, I just want you to realize that you're truly limitless. Anybody can do really anything. You are limitless. If there's one thing that I want you to know, that's you are limitless. Thank
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It was fantastic.